Hello everyone, and welcome back today for the return of F1 2021 setup videos. We're here going through every single track on the F1 calendar with all of my setups, the one that I use for both quali and races. Now, just to note, these aren't time trial quali setups. These are setups I've used in like a 50%, 100% lead race or whatever, but they don't change all too much, so you should be fairly comfortable with both. Just a quick notice before we get this underway, in the description below will be a timestamp for every track. So if you're not particularly interested in all of them, but you only want, let's say, Spa, then you can head over to that time and then have a go, you know, take that setup. And so we're going to go straight into it then. I think I've said all the things I need to say at the start. Feel free to adapt any of these setups to your personal adjustments if you want more wing, less wing, more anti-roll bar, whatever, etc, etc. So then, the first setup on the list is bar without the rein. We have 7-9 on the aerodynamics, 80-53 on the transmission, 3-2, 0.06, 0.2 for the suspension geometry. Suspension is at 1-1, 7-10, 4-7. So that's 1-1, 7-10, 4-7. For brakes, they are your, you know, whatever you feel comfortable with using. I tend to run 156 or 57, but it's 156 for this. And for the tyres, it's 2 from the left for the front 2 and all the way to the right for the bottom 2. Or in other words, it's 21.8. 23.5. A recurring theme through this video will be how creative I've been with the name of my setups on sustained spin span for the circuit to Barcelona. I use 10-9 wing. I know for some people use 8-9 or 9-9. I use 10-9 for that extra rotation. 80% and 50% on the transmission. All the way to the right for the front camber, and then the bottom three are all the way to the left. Suspension is at 1-1, 6-2, 4-7. So there's 1-1, 6-2, 4-7. Tire brakes are the same, and tyres are 1 from the right on all of them. So that's 24.6 and 23.1. We move swiftly on to Monaco Coco, where we have, you know, default 11 a wings, pretty bog standard. I think I actually used 11-9 on 10-11 last year, just for a little bit of straight line speed, because the cars had the downforce. Anyway, transmissions 55-55, which is 5 from the left, I think. Yeah, 5 from the left. So for suspension geometry, I'm using 3. 1.7, 0.06, and 0.29. Suspension is at 1, 3, 5, 1, and 2, 6. And tyres are at 22.2 and 23.1. We plough on through into Azerbaijan. 7-5 wing on the aerodynamics, 85-56% for the transmission, 2.81, 0.07, 0.2, could say 007 for the front toe. Suspension is 1.53927. That's 153927. And the tyres are all the way to the right, maximum tyre pressures. Next on the list is 4 hours, 4 minutes, and 39 seconds, otherwise known as Canada, in reference to the longest ever Grand Prix in history from 2011. 10-8 wings. 75%, 50%. all the way to the right for the front camber, and then the other three are all the way to the left. 2.52, 005, and 0.2. Suspension is 117426. 117426. Brakes, usual, and then tyres, 23.8 and 23.1. Next on the list is Ultimate Runoff. We're here for France, 7.9 wing for aerodynamics. Transmissions are 83%, 54%. Suspension geometry is all the way to the right, then 1.9, 0.05, 0.2, so all the way to the left for the bottom one, one from the left for the rear camber, and then all the way to the right for the front camber. Suspension is at 1.5, 3.6, 1.7. And the tyres are at 23 and 23.1. So that's pretty much in the middle for the front and one from the right on the rears. Next on the list, the hills are alive. Well, the hills are alive with the sound of my setups here for Austria, the Red Bull Ring. 9.5 wing. Definitely probably the most changed track from last year. I think I used 3.5 or 3.6 last year. But 9.5 on this year's game. 90%, 53% on the transmission. The suspension geometry is all the way to the right and then all the way to the left for the bottom three. 2.52, 0.05, 0.2. Suspension is 1.3, 1.6, 1.8. 1.3, 1.6, 1.8. And the tyres are all the way to the right, maximum tyre pressures. Heading off next to Britain for the lovely Silverstone, 5.7 wing. I feel like 5.6 wing is good enough if you're good at, you know, rear stability, like oversteering setups, but I use 5.7. Transmission is 88 and 54. The suspension geometry is looking one from the right, for the front camber, and then all the way to the left for everything else. Suspension 3.8, 2.7, 4.7. And the tyres are at 22.2, 23.1. That is Silverstone, done and dusted, onto Monaco but without the walls, aka the Hungaro Ring, located in the country of Hungary, 11.10 wing. 85% and 60% on the transmission. Suspension geometry then is one from the right all the way to the left, and the bottom two are just one from the left. Suspension is at 267547. That's 267547. The tyres are all the way to the right, 25 and 23.5. You head off to, that's Radion actually, for the Belgian Grand Prix. 7.4 wings. 85% and 55% on the transmission. All the way to the right, all the way to the left, 0.07, 0.23 is the suspension geometry. It's 2.52, 0.07, 0.32. Suspension is 222868. That's 222868. And the tyres are all one click from the right, at 24.6 and 23.1. Next on the list is Hello Dutchy for the Dutch Grand Prix. 11-11 wing, however, some people use 11-9 for the extra straight line speed. I tend to use 11-11, sometimes drop it down to 11-10 for a race just to be competitive down the straights. But transmission is at 80-50%. The suspension geometry is looking like all the way to the right and then all the way to the left for the bottom three. Front camber is all the way to the right. The suspension is 1-8-1-1-4-7. That's 1-8-1-1-4-7. And the tyres are all the way to the right, maximum tyre pressures. Next up is Forza Ferrari for the Italian Grand Prix. I think I was going to change the name of this setup, but I can't quite remember what I was going to change it to. Anyway, 7-3 aerodynamics, 7 on the front, 3 on the rear. 95% and 55% on the transmission. Suspension geometry, 2.7, 1.2, 0.07, 0.26. That's 2 from the right and 2 from the left for the front, for the camper and the tow. Suspension is 6-1-8-2-3-6. So 6-1-8-2-3-6. Tyres are 23.8 and 23.5. That's 3 from the right for the front, all the way to the right for the bottom 2. We're making good progress here for anyone who's watching it all the way through. We're on to Mazza win is greater than Mazza spin for the Russian Grand Prix. 10-6 wing, 10 on the front, 6 on the rear. Heading over to the transmission then, we have 85% and 50%. Suspension geometry is looking all the way to the right for the front camber and then all the way to the left for everything else. The suspension is 111226, so 111226. And then the tyres are 2 from the right in the front and all the way to the right for the rear. So that's 24.2. for the front, 23.5 for the rears. Not long to go now. We're here for the Crashgate Grand Prix. Singapore then, 11-11 wings, maximum downforce for the street circuit. 72%, 60% on the transmission. 2.8, 1.3, 0.06, and 0.2 on the suspension geometry. So that's 3 from the right, and then 1 from the left, all the way to the left. In that order. Suspension is 161, 628. So that's 16, 1628. And to finish. Tyres, 23.4 on the front 2 and 23.5 on the rear 2. So that's 4. Yeah, 4 from the right, almost in the middle. Up next is sushi time for the Japanese Grand Prix. Didn't know what to call them set up, so I called it sushi. 9-10 wing. 85 and 59% on the transmission. All the way to the right for the front camber, and then the rear camber, the front and rear toes are all the way to the left. Suspension is 141, 616. And then the tyres are all the way to the right, maximum tyre pressure. Here we go then, for USA, the United States of America, we're almost at the end, did we load that? I don't know if we did, but we're going to give it another go. 9-8 wings, need to get that good turn in for the first sector especially. 70% and 60% on the transmission. One from the right, two from the left, one from the left and then all the way to the left for the combo and tow. 2.6, 1.8, 0.06, 0.2. Suspension, 1.8, 10.1, 5.7. That's 1.8, 10, 1.5.7. And then the tyres are 22.2 and 22.3. The front and rears. Not long to go, we're on to Mexico for the Mexican Grand Prix. 11.8 wing, 80% and 55%. All the way, one from the right, two from the left, and then one from the left, and then all the way to the left, so same as USA for the suspension geometry. The suspension is 1.4, 8.2, 5.7. I believe that's the same as Mexico. But I can't remember. No, I don't think it was. No, I think the same as USA. I think this might have been 10 though. Can't remember, but it's 1.48, 2.57. And then the tyres are the same at 22.2 and 22.3. Anyway then, not long to go. It's that Glock going slow. For the Brazilian Grand Prix. Hopefully we'll get that little line. Now this one's probably my most uncertain setup. I run 10.6. Others run like 9.4. I think 10.6 is good. For the front and rear wing. And then I have 80%, 85% and 50% on the transmission. The suspension geometry is all the way to the right, all the way to the left. 0.08, 0.2, I think this is 3 from the left. Yeah, 3 from the left for the front toe. Suspension is 1.3, 1.2, 3.6. And then the tyres are 23.4 and 23.5 on the fronts and the rears. Onto the penultimate race of the F1 calendar, but not the one on the list. We still have Portugal and China to do. So, shoe for the boys. I think they've got a better name for the setup. 10.9 wing. Some people use 9.9, some people use 8.9. I use 10.9, similarly with Spain. Transmission, 75 and 55. The suspension geometry is all the way to the right on the front camber. Everything else is all the way to the left. The suspension is 111336, similar to a setup we had earlier. So that's 111336. And the tyres are all the way to the right, maximum tyre pressures. Time to load the Abu Boring Dhabi Grand Prix. 11.8 wing for the aerodynamics. Transmission is 90% and 52%. So that's one from the right, all the way to the left, and then one from the left on both toes. That doesn't sound front toe and rear toe. Sounds a bit better than both toes. Suspension is quadruple 2.47. So that's 2.2, 2.2, 4.7, double 2, double 2, 4.7, and the tyres are at 22.6 and 22.7. Something that's quite common is that the tyres will always be similar, whether it's like 22.3 and 22.2, but this one's 22.7, 22.6. Anyway, on to Portimao. Actually, I changed the name of the setup, but that hasn't loaded. You know what, we're going to do this live, we're going to see what I called it, called the setup. We're going to call it, there it is, Porta Mayonnaise. unfortunately, that hasn't saved, and it has really messed up my thingy. Actually, I've just noticed that it hasn't changed the last time I've done this. So that's concerning, because it's not the 28th of September at the time of recording. So when I've closed my game down and reloaded it, these setups haven't saved. But I don't think I made many changes. So if you're going to plow on through, I think these should be all my settings, but it might just be the names that have changed. Did I load the setup? I don't think I did. Yeah, there we go. 9-9 wins for Portugal. 80% and 50% on the transmission. All the way to the right, all the way to the left, all the way to the left, and then one from the left for the suspension geometry. 2.52, 0.05, 0.23. Suspension is 119217. That's 119217. Tires are all the way to the right. Last but not least, we have Shanghai, another track I don't have a proper name for yet, but it's 911 wings. Haha, that'd be funny. Transmissions at 90% and 54%. Suspension geometry all the way to the right, and then all the way to the left for the rear camber, front and rear toe. Suspension is 111, 42, 27. That's 111, 42, 27. And then tyres are all the way to the right but one for the front. So that's 24.6 and 23.5. And that brings an end to the setup video. You can see we've already started with the wet setup. But I think these should all be my accurate setup. Earlier when I said I think I changed the name of this one, definitely changed the name of it. I can't remember what I called it. Really can't remember what I changed it to now, which is annoying me. But I think everything else is stayed the same. The names aren't important. The setups don't matter. But I think these should all be the accurate setups. They're done on the 28th of September. At the time of recording, it's the 5th of October, so they're not actually too far apart. This Shanghai was for a league race, and that league race took place at the time of recording 6 days ago, which I think is close to the 28th of September. So yeah, these are all the correct settings. If you have a favourite name or setup, please let me know. We'll go through them quickly just for fun. We've got Bar Without the Rain, Spain Spin Span, Monaco Coco, Azerbaijan Grosjean, 4 hours, 4 minutes and 13 seconds, 2011, Ultimate Runoff, The Hills Are Alive, Rule Britannia, Monaco Without the Walls, that's Radeon actually, Hello Duchy, Forza Ferrari, Mazda Wins Greater Than Mazda Spin, Crashgate GP, Sushi, United States of America, Smexico, Is That Glock Going Slow, Chewy for the Boys, Abu Boring Dabby, Porter Mayonnaise, and Shanghai. I'll probably get a different name for Shanghai rather than Shanghai. I don't know, maybe Twisty Turn 1 or something. Who knows? Anyway, that is going to bring an end to this setup video. This has been a video for all my F1 2021 setups in the drive for the F1 2021 cars. Expect another video sometime in the future for all my wet setups. That video on F1 2019 has done really well. I think it's got about 700 views at the time of recording. So thank you very much for the views on that video, guys. And stay tuned for more F1 gameplay, further gameplay, more content that comes to the channel. And yeah, that's going to be it. Let me know if you use any of my setups. It'd be great to support you guys. If you don't know what the setups are, what they do, then the game does give an explanation, but I'm sure there are other tutorials out there. But yeah, that's going to be all from me, guys. Make sure to like and subscribe, leave a comment down below, share with your friends, get them to subscribe. And until next time, I'll see you later. Goodbye.